I've just had it, right, with Perplexity. If you don't happen to know, Perplexity is an AI tool, like ChatGPT and the rest, but it vowed to be ethical in how it trained itself, how it got information from the web, and how it always shows you its sources, except when it doesn't. And despite some, I mean, actually extremely irritating faults and errors in its responses sometimes, it became my favourite. I was using it every day. I stopped using Google for just searches and instead, easy, whacked it into Perplexity, got results, checked it out. And then the makers of Perplexity quite recently were accused of unethically scraping websites. And they kind of admitted that they had, well, there was a teething problem. But then this week, as I record this, they just tried it on. Yes, they said, we do this, so there, what are you going to do about it? It's fine, and you're all idiots for thinking that us stealing information from your websites and therefore making sure that those websites get no income and so they die is anything other than fine. I may possibly have made up some bits in the middle there. Let's throw in allegedly, although you can read the blog post. Yeah, that's the gist. And I just have had it. Once I read that Perplexity news, I dropped the app from my iPad, my iPhone, and my Stream Deck and replaced it with ChatGPT. Don't laugh. It is swapping one unethical scraper for one that might be and also wants to make money off all published works without paying for any of it. And ChatGPT is definitely known for kind of rubbing its hands at getting its mitts on your data. But I'm on the beta test for iPadOS 26. And iPadOS 26 and iOS 26 and macOS iOS have Apple Intelligence features in Shortcuts, which means I can ask ChatGPT questions, but do it via Apple Intelligence and so not let ChatGPT know anything about me or my devices or anything like that, and so not let it train on my questions and my prompts. Now, it doesn't make ChatGPT less of a problem overall for writers and anyone who ever does anything online or has any of their work ever put online by anybody. But it does make my end private. So if you have iPadOS 26, iOS 26, or macOS Tahoe, either because you're on the beta test as I am right now, or because you're watching after they've all been released properly and officially in September, October 2025 time, here's how to ditch Perplexity. I looked gleeful there, didn't I? Really got into me. Hello, I'm William Gallagher, and this is 58 Keys, which, as ever, as always, is for writers. And in this Wednesday edition, it's for writers like you and me who use and who write on Macs and iPhones and iPads. I do subscribe because we usually might have so much to talk about, and there's a fair bit today, but this time it's quick. Not quickish. We can do this at light speed because you could do this. On the iPad or the iPhone, press and hold the sleep-wake button to call up Siri. On the Mac, double tap the command key next to the space bar to get type to Siri. Then pop your question, your prompt in, and if Siri can't answer it, and these days, for some reason, Siri can barely tell you the time, it will send that query, it will ask you and then send the query off to ChatGPT and do so privately. The end, you're done. Except I don't find it all that useful. Somehow you do get an on-screen answer. And then if you spot the share icon, you can tap that and then tap copy and then the answer's on the clipboard. That's good. But I mean, seriously, that might be all you need. And in fact, saying this to you, I suddenly, why did I go further and make a shortcut to do this? Well, for this reason, I now have a button on my iPad's home screen. I have a widget on my iPhone and okay, as it happens, another physical button on my, I get obsessed, Stream Deck. And when I press any of these, my question, query prompt, whatever you want to call it, goes straight to ChatGPT. It's going via Apple Intelligence, but there's no waiting for Siri to throw up its arms and say, you're asking too much of me, can I get ChatGPT to help? None of that, straight to it. And if you make this as a shortcut, you can then make that shortcut do more things. So let's say you're researching something. You can have ChatGPT give you an answer or a hallucination. Why don't we just call them lies? I don't know. But then automatically save it straight to a research note that you're building up. Or not automatically, have it ask you, do you want to save this to notes or is this just too bad for words? Do you want me to email it to some edit? I am not kidding about how you can use Siri directly to use ChatGPT, to use it privately, and therefore to ditch Perplexity. But a shortcut is better for you and me as writers. Now, if you want the shortcut, let me say first that, well, I'll put a link to my version in the description, including a note as well somewhere in there about the one thing you seem to have to do to make it work on your devices instead of mine. And then let me show you how to make it all yourself. If you have iPadOS 26, iOS 26, or macOS Tahoe. The key thing is that this revolves right around a new shortcut action called Use Model. Most of the shortcut we're going to build is say, well, what do you want to know? And then telling you, well, this is what I think, telling you the answer it gets back. But just so you know, well, as much or as little as I do about shortcuts, here's the asking of it. But actually, let's just build a new one together. Build it from scratch. You see what you already know, what you don't, if there's anything, and see where you can find other things you might add. Now, I'm going to do this on the Mac, but exactly the same thing works on the iPad and the iPhone. And by that, I do mean that you can make the same thing on any of these devices, but then also, whichever one you make it on, they will automatically be on all of your devices, and you can run them all on any of them. There are differences in shortcuts, but nothing that applies here. To do this, open shortcuts, tap or click the plus sign to make a new one. Before you do anything else though, tap in that search action sections and start typing the words use model. If you do not get an action back listed there called use model, well then you are not on iPadOS 26, iOS 26 or macOS Tahoe, and this will not work for you at all. Not yet. Come back to me when you have them. And actually, as this first goes out in August 2025, it's only going to be a few more weeks' time before they are the official public releases. But assuming you have used model, well, forget it for now. Name your shortcut, right? On the Mac, you click where it says title and you just type something. On the iPad and the iPhone, well, you tap where it says new shortcut and then you tap on where it says rename on the menu that appears. You can also, if you choose, tap or click on the little icon next to the name and change the color, change the symbol, if you like. That's nice. Okay. Having done that, right, what you get is a blank shortcut, so a working space. Tap or click back in search actions, delete use model if it's still there, and instead search for ask for input. Now tap, click, or drag that ask for input action onto that blank workspace. Where it says prompt, enter something like, so what do you want to know? I mean, it could be anything. As long as you understand it, doesn't matter what you write it. It's just, this is what is going to be shown to you. It's what you're going to always see on the screen whenever you run this shortcut. So something sensible would be nice. I do suggest actually that you tap the disclosure triangle, the triangle and the circle next to it. And there are two things there. I can't imagine there's a default answer for every time you want to ask ChatGPT something. So yeah, leave that. But make sure that allow multiple lines is ticked. And that way you can enter an AI prompt later that's just a lot more complex than kind of single one line kind of thing. Now, the key part. Search actions, look for use model, tap or drag, and that's at the bottom now. In that use model action that appears, you know that it's click for a Mac and it's tap for an iPad and iPhone. Let's go with select. Select the bit where it says a private cloud compute, and then from this shortlist that appears, choose extension ChatGPT. In future, if you're watching this later, there may well be more options there. I used to hope Perplexity would be one of them, but yeah, there you go. Nonetheless, there will be ChatGPT. Choose that. This bit, the next time, it looks odd. In that box now, it's saying show for input, and you'd think that that means you could save a step, that you could just go straight to use model, but no. You can't forget that previous step, because that isn't what this means. It isn't asking for input here. What this means here is that the use model action will there use whatever you entered in the previous ask for input section. And that would be it. That is asking ChatGPT a question and doing it through Apple Intelligence so that it is private. But you do kind of need the answer back, don't you? Well, this is a little bit pointless. Let's see, run the list for me. You've got the shortcut to ask you what you want. You've got it chuck in the prompt question, whatever it is, over to ChatGPT, and there will be a response. A response will return, but you won't see it without taking some further steps. It's just that those further steps, they're kind of up to you. I'll show you mine, but, well, actually, there must be so many. But what I've gone for is, honestly, it's my first thought, my first two thoughts, really. Find the action called Quick Look and add that to the bottom. Then find the action that's called, Add to Clipboard and add that. Quick Look, if you don't happen to already know, it's a tool for debugging sugars, for finding out where they're going wrong. And they go wrong. What you do is you chuck a quick look action in halfway to see, for instance, what is the text that you're trying to send to chat? Bad example. Okay, good example, but far too detailed. Let me try to do this quickly. Don't ask. I have a shortcut, for example, that takes two times, right? And it works out the difference between them. Okay, when I was making that, I put in a quick look in just the right place so that I could see. The first thing was the time that was recorded earlier in the shortcut, and that the second one, the comparison one, was the time right now, the current date and time. Once I knew that was working, and then I hadn't, done it the wrong way around or something silly, I deleted Quick Look, and that's normally what you do. In this case, though, I'm actually using Quick Look as a way to display the response from ChatGPT. I know there's got to be a better way. But this is all I've got so far. Except for the second and the last step in this shortcut. Copy to clipboard. That takes the same response you saw in Quick Look and puts it on the clipboard so that you can just paste it anywhere you like. So we're back to that thing of typing to Siri, a thing you share, copy. But now, when you run this shortcut that you've just made, it asks you what you want to know. It chucks your query off to ChatGPT, then presents the answer first in the Quick Look window. Read it on screen, and then on the Mac, tap the space bar, or click the X actually on the Mac as well, or on the iPad and the iPhone, there is just the X. That's the only choice there, so you tap it. And then, if you want, paste that answer you just read anywhere you like. Now, that does kind of just leave one thing, I think, running it. You know all the buttons? This is never going to replace Perplexity or anything else if you first have to, open the shortcuts app, find this particular shortcut, and then run it. So skip all of that, make it a button. On the iPad and the iPhone, with the shortcut open on your screen, you can tap the share icon at the top and then tap Add to Home Screen. There's a place there where, you can change the color or the symbol, or actually, apparently even add a presumably small photo. But anyway, do that, tap Add when you're done, and now you have an app-like icon on your iPad or your iPhone's home screen. It's just like an app. You can drag it around as you would any app, or you could, for example, drag it into the dock on your iPad or your iPhone. On the Mac, you again have to have the shortcut open in front of you, but now you choose the File menu and you choose Add to Dock. There it is. If you don't want it in the dock, if you want it somewhere else on your desktop, well, you can right-click on it on the dock, choose Show in Finder. That will open a folder that contains the shortcut and place it wherever is convenient for you. And then when you click on that, it'll run it. And then you can just drag the original out of the dock. You could, though, also, just thinking this through, you could add this shortcut to a widget. Let's do Mac first this time. Right-click on a blank spot on the desktop, choose Edit Widgets. In the box that pops up, choose Shortcuts. There are options for, how many. I'm just going to drag the one for a single shortcut for now, but any of them will do. Drag that out to the desktop, position it vaguely where you like, and then click Done to get rid of the editing box. Right-click on that shortcut widget you've just made. Search through it for the shortcut that you want, and then click Done. From now on the Mac, you can just click on that widget to start all of this. Or on the iPad and the iPhone, very similar thing. Press and hold on a blank space on the home screen of either device and tap the Edit button that appears. From that little pop-down menu, choose Add Widget. Within that, find shortcuts, pick an option. Again, I'm just doing one that works for me, and tap add widget. Nicely though, since the ChatGPT shortcut is the last one you've just made, presumably, it may even default to that. But if it doesn't, tap on any blank spot on the screen to end the wiggling edit. And then to change the widget to that shortcut you want, press and hold on that widget. And now choose edit widget. Find the shortcut that you want and you're done. How long does that take? All of this, I tell you, this has taken 20 times longer to say to you than it did for me to think of it and to do it. That presumably means I could be more concise. But even if you have never used shortcuts before, this will not take you anywhere near as long as it's taken me to just talk about it. And actually, this is just one place, I think, actually, where a shortcut can be so deeply useful for you and me, specifically for us as writers. And so much so that, in fact, that very soon, very shortly, there's going to be a couple of 58 keys all about starting to use shortcuts and making ones we can benefit from. And in fact, I said a couple there. I'm going to split it in two parts. The first one of shortcuts before iPadOS 26, iOS 26, and macOS Tahoe. And then secondly, after those have been officially released. That's because the first part will be all about using shortcuts in general, and that will last forever, but the second will concentrate on this new Apple Intelligence Use Model action that I promise you is so useful, so great that is. There will be links to both of these 58 keys episodes in the description as soon as they are out. It'll be in the next few weeks, so one thing, gotta wait for iOS 26 and the rest to come out, but it'll be there. For now though, in five lines of a shortcut, we have ditched Perplexity and made ChatGPT behave itself, at least in terms of your and my privacy. It's not an answer. It's not an answer to the problems of AI, but it's a small one or two number fingers up to Perplexity. And that's it for this edition of 58 Keys. Do you remember the 58 Keys writing workshop videos that come out every Monday, and also the I'm Obsessed with Scripts, the script writing one on Fridays, but for now, thank you very much for watching. Take care of yourself, okay? And I'll see you soon.